Welcome to the Zohar class. Good evening, Shab Becher. Parashay Hafta has Lech Lecha, Sevomin Porshene, Ketob Bereshit, Ketob Kitoror Kazaval Shurukardim, Lech Lecha, Bemani, go out, go out of yourself. I'm sure که همه آشنایی داریم با داستان تورا جایی که بعد از برشید و نوح جایی که یک کاراکتر یک انرژی به اسم ابراهام به ما اینتریدیوس میشه و داستان تورا اینطوری که خدا بهش میگه از خونه پدریت از شهرت از کشورت بیا بیرون بیا برو به جایی که بهت نشون میدم در آینده و داستان ادامه پیدا میکنه به جایی که سرا بچه دار نمی شده سرا آفر میکنه که با کسی که باش کمکش میکرده هاگار بچه دار بشه ابراهامی بچه میره به اسم ایشمائل و بعد از وقتی که ایشمائل 13 ساله شد سرا بچه دار میشه و یه بچه میره به اسم ایتخاک و تورا قبل از اینکه به ایتاک برسه تو خشم به ابراهام میگه خودتو سیرکمسایز کن بریت میلا so we're going to learn about the significance of what بریت میلا is why we do this and ابراهام he's the first character in the Torah که یک گایدنسی به ما میده what kind of a life we should have what kind of a path we should have قبل از که بیشتر راجع به لخ لخان صحبت بکنیم چون تو کتاب برشید هستیم تمام کتاب های برشید یک introduction یک general view به ما نشون میده برای جورنی که تو زندگی باید داشته باشیم کتاب تورا هدفش اینه که ما به یه پوینتی برسیم به کتاب برشید و اون تمام درسای برشی تمام جورنی ابراهام و ایتاق و یعقوب به یه جایی ما میخواد برسونه و به اون آخر کتاب برشید به کجا ما میرسیم جایی که یعقوب اسم شد اسرائیل و صاحب یه پسر شد به اسم یوسف سو تمام هدف کتاب برشید اینه که ما به یه پوینتی برسیم که we gonna be called اسرائیل و بچه هامون به یه پوینتی برسن که بهشون بگیم صدیق که صدیق باشن رایچس باشن So what does it mean to be Israel? It means to be Israel به معنی اینه که من به ماها به ماکسیموم پتانسیالمون رسیدیم و we went above the star influences دیگه ما زیر اینفلوئنس ستاره ها نیستیم ستاره ها به معنی اون ساینی که داریم میدونیم هر ماهی ساین خودشو داره که اون نگتیو اسپکت های اون ساین ها ما رو کنترل نمی کنه اکسیدنت ها ما رو کنترل نمی کنن nothing happen outside is controlling us that what Israel means I do my job I grow I transfer I share I'm full of chesed compassion love no matter what's going on outside that's Israel و کشور اسرائیل is a wonderful example. ما we are surrounded by billion enemies and Baruch Hashem we are only growing, right? We only getting better in technology. We only getting better in medicine. We get better in agriculture. We get better in health. So no matter what happened outside, I have to reach my potential, my maximum potential. و به کتاب برشید به کجا ختم میشه به اونجایی که یعقوب 12 تا بچه داشت و همشون they were huge souls و مخصوصا یوسف که is called یوسف at صدیق so چیزی که تورا به ما میخواه یاد بده it's not enough که ما به maximum potential هم برسیم that's not enough it's good it's half of the job ولی the full picture the full jobی که ما داریم که بچه هامون هم righteous بشن وقتی ما به ماکسیموم پتانسیلمون برسیم و بچه‌هامون رایچس باشن then you know we are following the rules of the Torah then we have done our job. So righteous صدیقین kids not necessarily means that they have to be orthodox, not necessarily means that they have to have the biggest title in the world, they have to be good human beings, صدیقین. خیلی جالبه که کلمه صدیق به فارسی and Hebrew is the same word, so it's easy to understand. Righteous. So the goal of the book of Bereshit is that we become Israel, we are above any negativity, negative influences, and Israel میشه Yashar El, that means that I'm following, that I'm compatible, I'm aligned with the light of the Creator, which is full of chesed, kindness, compassion, joy, no matter what's happening outside, and having righteous children. So the first character that teaches us how to reach this goal is Abraham. Is Abraham. What is کلاس سعی میکنیم هر هفته یکی از کلاس های سال پیش رو لود بکنیم. I highly advise میکنم که کلاس ها رو گوش کنیم. We had a beautiful class about comfort. What does that mean to come out of your comfort zone? چیزی که هاشم به ابراهام گفت. چیزی که هاشم به ابراهام گفت گفت که start walking, move out of your comfort zone and I'm going to show you where to go. So اولین سوال اینه که چطوری, why he didn't show him? How come he didn't designate him an address? به ابراهام گفت start moving with no destination. و ابراهام از اونجایی که شروع کرد به travel کردن تا کشور کنعان اسرائیل, he met many nations. We studied that he met many nations. از این nation به این شهر به اون کشور, هر دفعه میرسید اونجا به اون شهره میگفت آیا این شهری که من خدا میخوام بهش برسم. He didn't have no clue where Israel is or what Canaan is. So هر دفعه که به هر جایی میرسیده شروع میکنه دعا کردن. This is the place God wants me to come. So we're going to learn اول از همه که destiny ما باید کجا باشه. درسته که we have to move out of our comfort zone, but where is our destiny? So به خاطر که comfort zone رو خیلی سریع توضیح بدیم که راجعش کلاس حرف زدیم, comfort zone نیست که من آدم تنبلی بشم یا لب استخ خوابیدم یا کار نمی کنم یا I'm lazy. That doesn't mean comfort. چیزی که تورا میگه از comfort zone بیاد بیرون, یه سری آدم ها هستن که با عصبانیت comfortable هم. یه سری آدم ها هستن بستگی به ساینمون داره, با جاج کردن comfortable هم. Judging is comfortable for me. It's very easy. I judge all day. That's comfortable. یه سری آدم هستن که همیشه عصبانی هستن. عصبانی بودن براشون comfortable میاد. یه سری آدم هستن که stress is part of their life. Workaholic. Being workaholic is comfortable for them. So وقتی که تو تورا میگه از کامفورت زونت بیاد بیرون, it's not out of your laziness, it's whatever you're comfortable doing, whatever is a negative character که ما داریم, negative behavior داریم, not necessarily laziness. So for some people it's very comfortable to go to China, for example, traveling back and forth, while they are neglecting their families. So come out of whatever is comfortable for you, because we are missing out on life by being stuck to what the stars, you know, telling me what to do. So چیزی که the Kabbalists میگن از کجا میدونست Abraham is the right place. میگو وقتی که داشته travel میکرده, he saw many nations که they were complaining, many nations that didn't have no rules, many nations humanity نداشتن, love نداشتن. وقتی که میرسه به کنعان, میبینه که آدم ها خیلی ارگنایزدن. They are very organized. همه چی با اردره. همه چی ارگنایزده. They are very serious. They are very exact. They are very persistent. And they are very precise. و یه پرپسی تو زندگیشون داره. وقتی که این آدم ها رو دید فهمید که this is the right place for him. And شروع میکنه دعا کردن. میگه هشم Can I stay here? This is the right. It looks like a right place for me. Can I stay here with these people? And then Hashem says, Yeah, you got it right. So there is more. We are supposed to come out of our comfort zone. We are supposed to یک جورنیای جدیدی پیک بکنیم to mindمون یا to physical world. چیزی که تورا به ما میگه Follow the people that have order in their life. Follow the people that have purpose to زندگیشون داره. Follow بکنین آدم هایی که serious هستن تو زندگیشون. We don't want to follow clowns and jokers and کسایی که هیچ border و هیچ limit و هیچ humanity تو خودشون نداره. So you're supposed to start moving, choosing new journey. Coming out of our comfort zone, we want to follow the people, the mentality, the society. We want the people, the consciousness, that which seriousness has, purpose has. There is order. There are persistent. As a general American, very big, asked, "What is your secret? What do you suggest to 18-year-old kid?" که میخواد زندگیشو شروع بکنه. گفت number one, when you wake up in the morning, fix your bed, set up your bed. So چیزی که جنرال داشت کنفرم میکرد که being organized is the number one secret to success. ما بروخ هشم هممون چوز کردیم تو ارس کارچرا سنتر باشیم, چوز کردیم زوهر و کابلا رو فالو بکنیم. And we see that there is a organization, there is this persistent rain or shine, you know, we come to Shabbat, you know, rain or shine, we have our classes, we don't give up, we are not wishy-washy, we are persistent, we are exact, we are have explanation, we don't leave any dark places, you know, everything is full of light, everything is full of understanding. So, Bezrat Hashem, us or children, we want to choose a new journey. This is the kind of characters we want to look into that new journey we want to take. In the new path that we want to take, you have to be full of organization, persistence. Everything is clear. There is an order. That's what Judaism is all about. Everything is by order. We have Shabbat, we had Chagim. We have time of prayer, we have full moon, we have new moon, right? So everything is order, everything is in exact. It's so funny, I came across some nations, calendarشون exact نیست. بعضی وقتا calendar اینطوریه, بعضی وقتا calendar اونطوریه. So they don't even know when is their holidays. So Judaism is so wonderful because there is an order. We are persistent. We read the Torah, we don't change the Torah. We everything in all the rules is unbreakable. You know, that's the kind of qualities we want to look into the new people we meet, into new journeys we want to take. The next lesson we are learning from Abraham. Avraham was a very wealthy man, you know, with his father, was a huge businessman, very famous. His father was making statues, making gods. Well, what was the secret of Avraham? Why Avraham is become more successful? Why har perekhay ke ma mikhunim migim be zuhud Avraham is from Yaakov? Why he lived forever? Chunke he didn't fall into the norm of the society. He didn't fall into the norm of the society. ما تو یه سنی هر چی که سوسایتی میکنه ما اوتوماتیکلی میخوایم فالو بکنیم. We want the looks, we want the wealth, we want the recognition. هر چی که سوسایتی نرمه ما میخوایم فالو بکنیم. هر اکسپکتیشنی که سوسایتی از ما داره میخوایم فورفیل بکنیم. Sometimes the expectation that our parents has is not correct. اگه توجه کنید تورا چی میگه به ابراهام؟ میگه از خونه پدرت بیاد بیرون، از شهرت بیاد بیرون، از کشورت بیاد بیرون. So especially our generation in this city we live, Hollywood, Baruch Hashem, is so hard to not fall into the norm of the society, to expectation of the society. So چیزی که ابراهام realize کرد، چیزی که ما باید realize بکنیم، هر کدومون گیفتای خودمون رو داریم، هر کدومون پرپسای خودمون رو داریم، هر کدومون پتای خودمون رو داریم. The society, I want to have the most money, I want to have the biggest house, I want to be the wealthiest, the richest, and the most good looking. For some people, شاید پرپسشون این باشه, but not necessarily for all of us. Maybe some of us have to be, not maybe, for sure. This society needs musicians. This society needs humble, loving people. This society needs, you know, teachers, students, kind, nice, you know, people. So we have to have this awareness that the path of my life is the path that my creator chose for me, not the path that the society is forcing me to follow. So that's a huge lesson from Abraham. In the Kabbalah language, every soul has his own purpose, has his own journey, his own path. We have to listen to our soul. We have to recognize what is the purpose for our soul. درسته که nothing against rich people or good looking people or big houses. This is their purpose. This is they were designed to bring wealth to the world. ولی همه دیزاین زندگیشون طوری دیزاین نشده. Some people their soul is designed to bring kindness, love, share the light, different jobs, different aspects, different level of society. So the Kabbalists say وقتی که ما پرپس سولمون رو داریم فولفیل میکنیم, the creator Hashem come to us 10 times, 10 times the distance که ما برداشتیم. یه قدم برداریم toward the destiny سولمون, Hashem 10 قدم میاد رو به طرف ما. ولی اگه خدا نکرده ما قدم برمیداریم به جایی که ما destiny نبودیم بریم, so Hashem, the creator, is concealed from us. The blessing is concealed. This world needs all different kind of people. Our job is not to find. Avram chi ma yad mide. Our job is not. Avram ma yad mide ki. Our job is not to follow the society. Follow what the purpose of my soul. That's how I become successful, healthy, happy, joyful. And then the light of Hashem is going to shine upon us. The angels, like Avram had the angel in his hand. The Kabbalists explain that there is 5 پنج تا درس خیلی قشنگ Avram به ما یاد داده. بجز این چیزه که با تون شیر کردم. And then we're going to start talking about Brit Mila. And then we're going to go to Talmud and Sefirot. It's a deeper level. اولین درسی که یه درس دیگه که ابراهام به ما میده, میگه که راجبش کم صحبت کردیم, که میگه soul همه perfecte. Everybody's soul is perfect. Soul هیچ کس هیچ کمبودی نداره. There is no bad soul. There is no sick soul. There is no poor soul. All the souls are perfect, beautiful, full of joy, full of love, full of health, full of blessing. So number one understanding is که within us درون ما تمام برخه ها وجود داره. برخه هایی که ما دنبالش هستیم از بیرون نیست. It's not from outside. It's from within us. چیزی که ابراهام ریکوگنایز کرد. ابراهام ریکوگنایز کرد که بلسینگی که درونش داره اون برخه هایی که درونش داره is beyond the life of his father, grandfather, اون کشوری که زندگی میکنه. اون منتالیتی اون بیلیف سیستمی که دارن باعث نمیشه که سول شاین بکنه. He needs to come out and let his soul shine. So our soul is perfect. ولی اون سرکمستنسی که خودمون توشو گذاشتیم باعث میشه که maybe we don't have joy, maybe we don't have happiness, maybe خسف شوالان we don't have health, maybe we don't see the blessing, maybe we don't see the happiness. So our soul within us is perfect. It has it all the blessing, all the barakah, all the success, all the refuah, it has it all. ولی اون سرکمستنسی که ما چوز کردیم خودمون توش بذاریم باعث میشه که این soul پوشیده بشه, قایم بشه, concealed بشه. So it's not like I'm gonna have more, I'm gonna be more beautiful, I'm gonna be more respectable, I'm gonna be more famous, اون موقع happy میشم. نه, that doesn't work that way. All the happiness and joy and love and barakah is within us, ولی اون circumstances که ما ایجاد کردیم که این soul conceal بشه رو باید removeش بکنیم. Wrong decisions, wrong people around us, wrong lifestyle, long communications. So تمام برخایی که دنبالش هستیم is within us. We just have to clear our mind. و تمام سال یاد میگیریم how it works. چیزی نیست که یک شبه بخوایم یاد بگیریم. It's just giving us some head letters برای تمام سال. پوینت دیگه ای که ابراهام به ما یاد میده اینه که how often do I listen to negative voices in my head. میگه که اون سوسترایی که ابراهام زندگی میکرد all negative people, idol worshippers, no rules, no regulations, no order, and full of negative thoughts, negative characters. Abraham might go, okay, you know what? I don't want to listen to negative thoughts in my head. I don't want to listen to negative thoughts. So we have to check. هر روز خودمون رو check بکنیم. Do I listen to any negative thoughts come to my head? Be jealous, scream, bitterness, you know, dark thoughts, act selfishness, you know, get angry. So we have to get to the point what Avram is teaching us. Don't listen to the negative thoughts that come to your head. اگه هم میاد بگیم بروخ هشم. You know, I have a, now I'm aware of it که بتونم اینو overcomeش بکنم. Push it away. Push away a negative thought is a huge transformation. اگه یه thought negative تو mindتون اومد و پوشش کردین away, be very happy. چون که یه طبقه اومدین بالا. You're not going to follow that old you. You're going to follow the new you که push away negative thoughts. The third point, چیزی که ابراهام به ما یاد میده, اگه یادون باشه, اگه وقتی که جوان بودیم, وقتی که سینگل بودیم, when we were young, we were choosing a career, یا بچه هامون که الان میخوان آیندهش رو نگاه بکنن میگن I want to become lawyer, I want to become doctor, I want to become rich, همه شو میگن I want to become rich. So چیزی که ابراهام داره به ما یاد میده اون چیزی که ما میخواییم بشیم it can take us away از اون پتی که برامون دیزاین شده. اون چیزی که من میخوام بشم not necessary is منو ما رو گونه lead بکنه to happiness, to joy, to blessing and barakah. گفتیم اگزمپل چاینا رو دادیم. If I want to go to China, do business in China back and forth, I'm not going to see my family, I'm not going to see my friends, I'm not going to be able to come to my kenisa. So it's not what I want. چیزی که ابراهام داره به ما یاد میده که we have to say what I don't want to become. This is such a beautiful lesson. What I don't want to become. So میدونم الان یک شاید جوانامون میخوان یه جورنی انتخاب بکنن. It's a great lesson to teach them what I not want to become. I don't want to become stressful life. I don't want to become, you know, miserable because I'm going to have overheads I don't cannot handle. I don't want to travel too far because I'm going to miss on my family. I don't want to choose a job that's going to take me away from my kenisa and my Torah. So it's not only برای جاب انتخاب کردن، برای پرسونالیتی مونه. If we choose to become, you know, the most famous people, is that the right thing for you? So, you know, میبینیم که هیستوری به ما یاد داده هرچی که مردم فیموس‌تر میشن تو اخبارو میبینیم، تو هالیوود میبینیم، they become more miserable, they become more, you know, they have a tough life. So we have to ask ourselves, that's Avram teach us, what I don't want to become before or what I do want to become. And then کمکمون میکنه که پتمون رو کنه. Of course, we want our children to be happy, successful. I want our children to get married, you know, with the right people. So we don't want our children to be lost. So we have to make the right decision today, you know, in order for our children to be happy. So choosing what I don't want to become is very, very powerful lesson. چیزی که ابراهام درس دیگه به ما میده تو این قسمت درس چهارم، میگه که هر روز باید ریویو بکنیم، هر روز باید ریفلکت بکنیم. How was my behavior today? You know, how was my behavior today? Avraham, on a daily basis, he was checking on himself. He definitely didn't want to become like his parents and his society. So on a daily basis, we have to review our behavior. یک پرکتیسی که تمام کابالیست‌ها میکنن بهش میگن شمع شل میتا، شمع اسرائیل، که وقتی مال تخت خوابه. You review, you see what you done wrong. And you try to correct it. اگه ریویو نکنیم، we keep going back. We keep doing the same mistake. We keep hurting ourselves and other people. So reflecting and reviewing on a daily basis is very important on a daily basis. همونطوری که صبح از خواب بلند میشیم، تفیلینمون میذاریم، تفیلامون رو میخونیم. We want to start a wonderful day and we promise and we're going to follow the rules of the Torah and the Siddur. In the end of the day, we have to see how we did, how we are doing. You know, what can I correct so the next day I'm not going to hurt myself or others? The last point of this section, the fifth point of this section, Avraham, هیچ وقت نگفت که I'm good enough or I'm okay. I'm good enough or I'm okay. ابراهام همیشه میگفت How can I be a better person? از خیلی میپرسی How you doing? میگه I'm okay. میگم بهشون میگیم بیا یه درسی با هم بخوریم. No, I'm good enough. I know enough. So ماها تو لول okay و good enough نمیخوایم باشیم. We want to always push to become a better person. خیلی برای کسی که درس تورا رو شیر میکنه و همیشه curious، همیشه is looking to learn more and be a better beacon of light، خیلی دردناکه. یه نفر میگه بهش میگه که no, I'm okay. I'm good. Leave me alone. Because we have so much potential. پتانسیل ما اون نیست چیزی نیست که داریم پتانسیل ما اونیه که هنوز بهش نرسیدیم It's so amazing هرچی که ما داریم فکر میکنیم we are okay and we are good enough there is thousand times the Kabbalah says there is thousand times هنوز منتظرمونه It's hidden It's concealed و میتونیم بهش برسیم وقتی که بگیم I want to become better I want to do better I want to grow So هیچ وقت نه to the pointی که anxiety برامون بیاره ولی we don't want to be good enough and we don't want to be okay we are pushing to be a better person now wow it's 8 o'clock already so now we're going to go to the next level we're going to go to the Zohar and to Talmud Ten Sefirot. گفتیم راجع به بریتمیلا میخواستیم حرف بزنیم. ولی قبل از اینکه به بریتمیلا برسیم we're going to talk more about Avraham. چیزی که اول کلاس گفتیم که هدف ما اینه که بشیم اسرائیل و بچه همون صدیق بشن هدف ما پلیجر تو دنیا نیست. دیدین آدم هایی که خیلی ماتریالیستیک هستن فقط دنبال پلیجر هم. The best comfortable life, the best lifestyle, easy lifestyle, pleasure, traveling. Nothing against that. ولی for the Kabbalist, it's the goal of life is not to become, to have pleasure. The goal of life is to become صدیق. که ما صدیق بشیم. حالا این جورنی صدیق شدن و صدیق بودن پلیجرش is infinite is million times پلیجرش بالاتر از پلیجرهای فیزیکلی یه مثال خیلی ساده شبات 20 years ago هممون شباتا لب دریا بودیم میخوابیدیم میرفتیم شاد سینما we had a good time ولی باروخ هشم نا وی هف شبات اینه کنیسا Would you give up the Shabbat for any other pleasure out there? Would you? I wouldn't. So the pleasure of being close to Torah, the pleasure of being sadiq and righteous is thousand times better than the physical pleasure. So pointی که میخواستم بهش برسم pleasure کدوشا Pleasure که با کدوشا باشه it lasts forever, lasts a lifetime, lasts a many lifetimes and it's keep coming and it's the true pleasure. Pleasure کدوشا Shabbat, Chagim, a kosher family, a good kosher house that's a pleasure that lasts forever for many many generations. That's connected actually to the Brit Milah, and let's talk about that now. What is this Brit Milah? Why Avraham did Brit Milah to himself, Ishmael, to Yitzchak, and to the whole household he had? Avraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov, ina umadan correct bokonan un khatayi ke Adam arishon kard. همه ماها اومدیم کرکت بکنیم یه نگاتیو کاراکترایی که درونمون هست the purpose of us being here is to correct to improve to tikun olam و سه تا میجر تیکون هست که هر کدومش دنیاه number 1 is گیلوی عرایوت is sexuality number 2 is عبوده زره is like different gods یک consciousness یک فیلسوفی که is foreigner to Judaism and سومیش از شفیخ دمیم killing people که خدا نکرده nobody kills you know in the actual meaning of it ولی we can kill people with our mouth we can kill people with our eyes so this is the three main corrections and they are all huge they are not به این سیمپلیستی که من میگم نیست it's going to take 6,000 years to correct them and به ذاتش we're going to do it so one of the correction is sexuality اگه زهر رو نگاه بکنیم، زهر کتاب 3 صفحه 145 توی این 10 تا سفیروت، درخت 10 تا سفیروت رو به ما نشون میده. Tree of Life. درسته که ما وقتی راجع به سفیروت حرف میزنیم همیشه از بالا به پایین میایم، میگیم کتر، خب ما بینا، ولی صفحه 145 زهر 3، ولی این ریالیتی تن سفیروت ماها از پایین شروع میشه، یارین ملخوت، و بعد این لدره رو باید بریم بالا. We have to keep going up in the ladder تا خودمونو به بینا برسونیم. So the first step for us is yesod. Yesod is our sexual organ. Is our yesod is compatible to our sexual organ. So, اولین استپی که ما باید برمی‌داریم برای اسپریچوالیتی، برای بهتر شدن، برای صدیق بودن، برای بلسینگ رسیدن، is to correct the خطا and the concept of sexuality. توی زهر اکسپلین می‌کنه که در هر گیتی there is always a negative force assigned شده، negative force وایساده، one of the employees of Satan. در هر گیتی، به خاطر همین ما مزوزا میزنیم در خونه هم. At every opening there is one of the employees of Satan is standing waiting for opportunity. هرچی که نورش بیشتر باشه، قدرت اون ساتان هم بیشتره، قدرت اون نگتیف فورس هم بیشتره. The most powerful part of our body is the sexual organ. We create life. یک چیز تازهی تو دنیا میاریم. تو این دنیایی که ما هستیم، اگه میز درست میکنیم، از یه چوبی درست کردیم. هرچی که میسازیم، از یه چیزی که آردی بوده، ما درست میکنیم. تنها چیزی که ما قدرتشو داریم، از هیچی درست بکنیم، is children and is through our sexual organ. So our sexual organ has the biggest power, also the biggest soldier, the biggest employee of Satan is also sitting and waiting by our sexual organs. So the sexual organ was made for us to have a pleasure by Kedusha only for Kedusha. True kedusha, with our spouse, only to create life. That's the only purpose of it. Of course, we have to have pleasure. Of course, we have to enjoy it, but only by kedusha, only by your spouse. But of course, we know in this complicated society, maximum by social media, by internet, you go buy a tire. They show you a sexy lady to sell you a tire. So we are so occupied by exactly the opposite of what we are supposed to be. So our generation has a huge challenge. How can we stay in our path of Kedusha with all these negative influences? So in order, the first step for us to get higher in the level of 10 sefirot is to correct the sexual aspect of it. But sexuality is dota shakhe dare. One is action, the other one is thoughts, speech, what I hear, what I see, what I think, what I smell. So yeah, you know, maybe one person, he says, you know what, I stick to my spouse, but they keep talking and thinking and imagining and seeing and hearing negative sexuality که deceivement میکنه از اون journey که باید داشته باشیم. So number کاری که the Judaism practice که میکنن is circumcision for 8 years old boy. Number one, it's an act, it's a covenant که هممون ویتنس میکنیم که sexuality is only for kedusha, is only for creating life with your spouse only. و فرقی که میکنه بین circumcised man and circumcised uncircumcised man اینه که circumcised man is kadosh, is kedusha. وقتی که ریویل میکنن اون پارتیو که کنسیله زوهر کالت کدوشا. We reveal the kedusha. So there is love. وقتی که میگیم کدوشا ریویل میشه یعنی اون acte is only for love. اون acte is only for compassion and care for my spouse. Uncircumcised is like a behema, is like animalistic. There is no love, there is no order, there is no kedusha, there is no purpose, it's only for selfish pleasure. So in order, what Abraham wants to teach us, you want to go to the next level, you want to achieve blessings in life, you want to achieve beracha, we have to stop, you know, what we talk about sexuality, what we see about sexuality, what we hear about sexuality, what we desire in sexuality. You know, the Torah, the age of marriage in the Torah, according to Judaism, is 20 years old. Bisalagi. Chera, chunke, the Creator knows we have desires, knows we have urges. Our body needs companion. So instead of getting lost into these pleasures and ta'ava, the assigned marriage is for 20, and 20 is not an accident. By the age 13, we complete the nefesh aspect of our being. But and another 7 years, which is the lower seven sefirot, we receive the ruach. So by the age of 20, we completed the nefesh and the ruach. And now we are ready for our neshama, that we're going to receive our neshama with our spouse, husband or wife. So the Torah is aware of these urges, pleasures, desires, satisfactions. That's why they assign the age of marriage for 20. You can go and have the best pleasure and best fun with your wife, but that's a Jewish life order dictate us. No talking about it, no hearing about it, no joking about it, not seeing it, not imagining it, not fantasize it, and definitely not to act upon. You know, only in a marriage borders we want to be. I know it sounds really restrict, but look at our life. A joke can take us so far. You know, a joke. Yeah, why we think the funniest jokes is about sexuality? Because the Satan is waiting for us. He gives us this temporary pleasure to steal the kedusha from us. So that's the reason, you know, Avraham circumcised himself, and there is a huge chapter of the Zohar about this. Let's talk about other aspect of Avraham. یکی از سیکرت‌های Avraham اینه که توی Torah که اسمش Avraham بوده بعد میشه Avraham. یه هی بهش اضافه میشه. Numerical value of هی is 5. این 5 تا چی هن که اضافه شدن به ابراهام؟ و قبل از اینکه به اونجا برسیم، اسم ابراهام از الف بت رش درست شده. ever به زبان عبری یعنی body parts. So the Kabbalists explain ما میکنن what Abraham did. He start controlling his body parts. که one of them is the sexuality. چیزی که ابرام و ابراهام کرد که یک level رفت بالاتر، he was controlling his body parts. What body parts? What is this heye ki besh ezafe shode? 5 ta hesaye ke ma darim, the 5 senses. Didan, shenidan, buidan, taste kardan and dast zadan. So Avraham is teaching us, you want to go to your next level, you want to reach Israel, you want to have a sadiq children, You have to start controlling your body parts. Ever به امری یعنی body parts. کسی که کابالا میخونن for many years میگه که numerical value Abraham is 248, right? مثل شما ایسرائیل که میگیم هر دفعه ما شما ایسرائیل میخونیم به تموم عضو بدنمون با کمک ابراهام blessing میاریم. So Abraham is teaching us control your body parts, control your eye, control your mouth, control your ear. Nose و قلب is related چون که nose به معنی عصبانی شدن. دیدی وقتی نفس عصبانی میشه یک نفس عمیق میکشه. So control your heart, control your hate, your anger, and control what you're touching. So Abraham is here in این guidance که تو تورا به ما داره میده، این پتی که تورا به ما داره میده، control your body parts. That's the key to success in this coming year. بعد خیلی جالبه، ما همیشه تو کابالا صحبت از این میکنیم have a عین توبا، have a good eye, have a positive eye. Have everything you see is good. But همیشه این سوال پیش میاد. Come on, how can you see good? How can you see everything positive? I have a huge secret to share with you guys. Abraham کاری که کرد، بعد یکی دیدنه، یکی که how can I see always positive، یکی امونه. How do we reach امونه؟ ایمان یا certainty. اگه من هرچی درس بخونم، هرچی بیشتر تو را بخونم، امونم بیشتر میشه؟ آیا امونا is intellect؟ آیا امونا خخما و ویزدوم؟ هرچی من خخمام بیشتر بشه، امونام بیشتر میشه؟ ها دو هرچ امونا؟ ما همیشه به هم دیگه میگه هف امونا، right؟ امونا تو بیشتر کن. Can you buy امونا؟ ها دو هرچ امونا؟ How come you guys never ask me how to reach امونا؟ ما میدونیم I don't want to judge, ولی خیلی آدم ها هستن که خوندن نوشتن بلدن نیستن، ولی اموناشون از ما بیشتره. Right? I know people like that. پس امونا doesn't come with intellect. امونا doesn't come if we know many professors, we know many huge lawyers, huge doctors. They don't know anything about emuna. Again, we're not judging, we're just exampling for the purpose of learning. So we know a lot of wise people اصلا خصف شلام خدا رو نمیشناسن. پس امونا doesn't come with intellect. How do we receive امونا؟ I didn't have امونا 20 years ago. What I did that I have امونا today. So the secret of امونا and the secret of seeing good and positive, I'm going to share it with you now. Abraham, the Torah, Hashem is telling us, you control your mouth, you control your ears, you control your nose and heart. I'm gonna give you a gift, gift of seeing positive and gift of emunah. So again, seeing positive is not easy. Having emunah, how do you reach emunah? چیزی که ابراهام به ما یاد میده، میگه دهنتو کنترل بکن، گوشتو کنترل بکن، انگر و عصبانیت و هیت و دیزایرت و تعوات و کنترلتو کنترل بکن. I'm gonna give you the gift of seeing good and I'm gonna give you the gift of emunah. Okay? تو شبات مصحف اونجا که میگیم کتر ایتنو لخا. وقتی که ما شبات ها بگو through the whole process of شخری، through the whole process of Torah reading، Torah هم بر میگردونیم و مصحف رو میخونیم، اونجا که میگه کترید نولخا، اونجایی که ما گیفت امونا میگیریم و گیفت دیدن پوزیتیو رو میبینیم. دیدن پوزیتیو it's not easy. You know, I didn't see positive 20 years ago, ولی بروخ هشم, you know, I see more and more positivity. It's a gift. It's a gift, and you can only have it by controlling your mouth, controlling your ears, and controlling your heart, which is explained kardim, anger, or hate, or control, or judging, or ego. You control your ego, you control your mouth, your ear, you're going to get a this amazing gift. So Avraham, Aleph Bet Resh, is the secret of Evarim, ever with any body parts. You have to control the body parts. Va un hei ke ezafe mishod ba Avraham ke totale DNA sh avaz shod. اگه میخوام DNA زندگی ما عوض بشه اون جایی که الان هستیم به بهتر you have to, all we have to do is control mouth, ears and heart. Controlling mouth, this mouth is not our mouth, it's a Hashem mouth. You want only berakha, blessing, only encouragement, empowerment to come out of it. Ears, we want to hear whatever is good for us, you know, whatever is good for a Jew to hear. A Torah, a good teacher, a good wisdom, a positive, you know, good, and remove that. همونطوری که یک چیزی که از سکشوال ارگان پسرمون ریموو میکنیم بهش میگن اورلا، همینطوری اورلا هم رو قلبمونه، یه اورلا هم رو زبونمونه، ولی اینو ما خودمون باید بکنیم. اون هیت و انگر از قلبمون باید در بیارید و اون نگاتیویتی از زبونمون باید در بیارید. If you want to take one lesson from this Zohar class, control your mouth, control your heart, control your ears, and the rest is going to come to you as a gift from Hashem, all the blessing. So let's go to the Avraham, and then Yitzchak and Yaakov is like a schooling. They're teaching us, they're schooling us. So Bezrat Hashem, every week we're going to learn about these characters and they're going to guide us. So let's go to page Zohar number 3, page 147, که صحبت از این سکشوالیتی میکنه. سکشن 274. با خوندن این سکشن Bezrat Hashem, با خوندن این قسمت زوهر, we want to remove all the talks, all the speech, all the jokes, whatever we hear, whatever is not kadosh for us from our life, and bring order and bring beracha and kedusha to our thoughts and the sexual behavior. Ta chazai bekadmita yahav kadosh berechu chokhma le'avraham. מנדה חוכמה להתבקה ביה, וידה רזה דמיימנותה, אבל למללה עמיה לא הובה, אלא היי דרגה תתאה בלוחודי, כיוון דתגזר כולו דרגין עלין הרבה שרעון, על הו דרגה תתאה, בגין למללה עמיה ובכדין אסתלג אברהם בכולה במה דאיתמר. סקשן הפעדי כתוזוהר מכונים is 149, میگه when you control the sexuality هم از نظر فیزیکلی هم از نظر speech and hearing and thoughts when we control it another gift we get is a soulmate. It's so amazing, you know, soulmate. And soulmate is not only for men and women, soulmate is for job, you know, for friendship, for good neighbor. Can you imagine if you talk dirty jokes and you talk about, you know, dirty pictures? Who wants to be your friend? You know, what kind of a people you attract yourself? You know, what kind of a society, who's going to be around you? You know, if you keep talking, you know, about concept that there is no kedusha in it, who are you going to attract yourself? Who are you going to attract your children, soulmates? Or Chasv Shalom, if you talk about foreign philosophies or other religion in our house, what kind of a soulmates we're going to attract to ourselves or children? So our speech, our thoughts, our conversations is only about Judaism, Torah, and Kedusha, because we want to meet our soulmates, you know, in business, in friendship. You know, if somebody come to our Kenisah to class and say constantly dirty jokes, do you want him among you? We don't want him among you, among us. So we have to distance ourselves from this negativity in order to find our soulmates. We think, I'm not a religious person, I'm not preaching for you to be religious. It's not about religion, it's a technology. It's a technology. The key to success, to barakah and blessing, is stay away from all these negative forces. So we are in page 149. It was very important for me. We're going to read this section in order to have a kedusha in our eyes, in our mouth, in our ears, in our heart, so we attract the right soulmates for ourselves and for our children. Ourselves as far as friendship, business, and for our children, the soulmate to get married. We're in page 149, section 279. קדישה בריחו ברין אלמין ומיען עינין זיווגין דבני נסו דה מהו זימנה קדושה בריחו מזווג זיווגין ואומר בת פלוני לפלוני ואלין עינן אלמין דהו ברי. The next section we're not going to read, we're just going to talk about it because we're short in time. It's page 150. I highly recommend که همتون تو خونه بخونید. میگه که سیکرت دیگه ابراهام که به ما یاد میده، ابراهام استادی تورا all his life، ولی هیچ وقت نیومد از راه تورا پول در بیاره یا از راه تورا یه به مقامی برسه یا یه ایگو بگیرتش بگه من تورا بلدم، من کابالا بلدم. So Abraham is warning us. You study Torah, wonderful. You know Kabbalah, amazing. You practice it, you share it, phenomenal. But don't wear this garment of selfishness with the Torah. میگه تورات خوندن و کابالا یاد گرفتن نباید باعث این بشه که یک لباس ایگو تنت بکنی. We have amazing, wonderful rabbis, and Baruch Hashem, they are knowledgeable, they are wonderful. ولی you know, we have to be aware که ایگوه تک اوورمون نکنه. Knowledgeمون باعث نشه که we asking for respect, we asking for recognition. Or that's fine, you know, if this is your position to make money, ولی not to deceive and abuse people by the name of Torah to make money. So this is what Abraham is warning us, you know. All the study, all the Torah, all the Kabbalah you want, but you have to be selfless and you have to be the channel of this light with no expectation, with love and sharing only in mind. The next section, the last section we're going to talk about, page 153, is one of my most favorite section. Safi 153. 153-154, paragraph 288. Abraham be connected to the Aramaic language. میدونیم تورا به زبان عبریه، یه سری از تفیلای ما به عبریه، ولی زوهر is in Aramaic. ما کدیشی که میگیم when we say the Kaddish is in Aramaic. میدونم بعضی هستن که عبری بلد نیستن، they cannot differentiate. ما وقتی میگیم کنیسا تمام تفیلا با زبون عبریه، وقتی که به زبان کدیش میرسیم یه دفعه میشه Aramaic. یا وقتی که در خلو باز میکنیم بریخشمه رو وقتی میخونیم، بریخشمه is in Aramaic. Right فرما جون؟ So we have two languages. We have Hebrew and we have Aramaic. Torah is Hebrew, Zohar is Aramaic. The Kaddish is Aramaic, Birch Shemeh is Aramaic. اون چیزی که تو پسخ میخونیم هلخمه اون دست Aramaic. So چیزی که ابراهام به ما توصیه میکنه تو این سیکشن، connect yourself to Aramaic. ببینید هیبرو پرپس خودشو داره، ارامیک پرپس خودشو داره. هیبرو is for خیلی به زبون ساده است. For our physical world, that's why we have the Torah is a physicality of it, is the Torah. And Aramaic is for the spiritual world. زبون Aramaic, there is no negativity in it. That negative force, I don't want to say even his name right now, doesn't know this language. So when we want to connect to Hashem, you know, we speak directly, we speak Aramaic because there is no negativity in it. There is no force that there is no negative force can influence this connection. But of course, we cannot abuse it. There is a time for Hebrew, there is a time for Aramaic. And the whole Zohar is in Aramaic. یک لقبی که به زوهر میدن چیه؟ میگن زوهر is the soul of the Torah. So the Torah is the body, the Zohar is the soul of the Torah. So Avraham recommend میکنه be connected to Aramaic and in reality be connected to Zohar. And that's going to eliminate the negative influence in our connection to the Creator. So that's why I read, that's why my teachers, that's why it's we read the Zohar in Aramaic in every class. Because هرچی درسی که خوندیم, we want to manifest it, we want to connect it with Aramaic language to take it to the higher realm. So that was the last advice from Avraham Avinu, be connected to Aramaic. You know what? Since we talk about soulmates, there is another section. I care so much about our children. Yeah, تمام بچه های اسرائیل, تمام جوان ها و سینگل ها. I know we don't have time, ولی I'm going to make the stretch. این سکشن هم میخونیم که به ازات هشم our young, all of our young going to find their soulmate. چون که این سکشنیه که eventually Avraham is going to look for a soulmate for his son, Yitzchak. Right here. We are in book number 3, صفحه 188, سکشن 352. This is a section که صحبت از soulmate پیدا کردنه. و چیزی که این سکشن میگه, میگه یک نفر هر چی که داره باید بده به خاطری که یک سولمیت تلمید خاخام پیدا بکنه, ازدواج بکنه. Look how far تلمید خاخام یعنی کسی که is spiritual, of course Jewish person. So زوهر میگه a man should give away everything he has. Everything on this planet, all the money, all the properties, whatever he has, all the titles, in order for him or his children, marry a Talmid Chacham. Talmid Chacham is somebody that studied Torah, somebody that is Jewish, somebody is a spiritual person, somebody is connected to his soul, neshama, as a Jewish neshama. So I hope it's not coming from me. You know, I'm just a channel to pass on the Zohar. And I cannot emphasize enough. He says a man should give everything he has in order for his children to marry Talmid Chacham. Talmid Chacham is a wise student, and the only wise student we have is Jewish people. In a راه تو راه تورا and Judaism. So با این کوانای سیکشن رو میخونیم که به ذات شم all the children of Am Yisrael find their good Jewish soulmate. Amar Rabbi Chaya mi'an de'at kashran of a diu be'an atal hitba hahu zivuga deliya amar lo ha tenin לעולם ימכור אדם וכולי, וישא בת תלמיד חכם, תלמיד חכם, פקודנה דמעריה את פקדון בידיה. רבי חיה ask, רבי חיה is not the accent, they use the word חיה, the name חיה, חיה means life. You want life? You want livelihood? So we have to find a Talmid Chacham for a soulmate. Rabbi Chaya asked, where should he who perform good deeds look for his soulmate? He answered, we have already learned that a man should even sell all his property to marry the daughter of a sage. Sage is somebody that is a spiritual Jewish, study Torah. We have already learned that a man should even sell all his property to marry the daughter of a sage, because the deposit of the Holy One, blessed be He, is handed over to a sage. Wow, میگه اون خدا قطره خودشو دپوزیت میکنه توی تلمید خخام, توی a sage, somebody that's studying Torah, somebody that followed Judaism. Therefore, he shall surely find his soulmate with him. I think I made a good point. Thank you very much. I wish you guys Shabbat Shalom. I love you guys. Thank you for being in this path and journey with me. Bezrat Hashem, we're going to achieve. We're going to reach our potential. I wish you Shabbat Shalom, Kol Tov, and see you on Shabbat.